up, everybody? Welcome to Keto Vlog 23. We're going to start today's video off with a physique check. But before I do, I did weigh in this morning, but I didn't get to record it. I was 166.6, so I am steadily coming down, and there is a reason for that. That reason being, I am starting to do intermittent fasting, but I'm really doing intermittent fasting for 16 hours. Normally, I would intermittent fast anywhere from 10 to 12, but this time I'm doing 16 straight hours, and I feel leaner. The one thing I was really worried about, it was, man, am I going to have enough energy for my CrossFit class? I'm going to have enough energy throughout the day only for fasting for that long. And I will tell you this, guys, surprisingly, I feel fine. One thing about hunger and intermittent fasting, hunger comes in waves, guys. It really does. There'll be sometimes throughout the day, especially when I'm fasting, you know, I'll get hungry and I'm like, you know what? I just tell myself, look, this is just coming in a wave. It'll pass. I drink some water, have some coffee, and boom, I'm not hungry anymore. I did not eat until about, yesterday I didn't eat till about 7 o'clock. I fasted for like, I don't know, more than 16 hours, and I felt fine. I did my CrossFit class. I felt great. I got home. The first thing I did was just kind of just chill. I had some water. I wasn't even that hungry. So I will say this, guys, if you hit a plateau or, you know, you just can't lose any more weight, try intermittent fasting. It's something that I'm trying out, I'm experiencing with. And hey, I had a good low weigh-in, and I'm going to show you how my physique looks. So it's something I'm going to start incorporating a little bit more and try to go minimum 16 hours intermittent fasting. Energy levels are fine. Workouts are fine. I don't feel depleted. I feel great. So here we go. Alright, so I'm in my car right now, gonna have my first meal of the day. Been fasting for a good part of it. It's currently 3 o'clock. Yeah, I know. So, let me show you what I'm snacking on for today. I got about 5 ounces of chicken breast. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. Put a little bit of Cajun spice. I have some sour cream. And then I have some celery. So, this is what I'm going to snack on. And this technically will be my first meal of the day. Now, you guys got to remember, it's 17.5 today. I haven't brought that up. I was kind of meaning to hold back on it because I'm technically filming 2 videos today. So, anyways, 17.5. You know, I say this now, it doesn't look hard, but I know it's going to be hard. So, as always, I'm super excited to show you how I'm going to do. Call me crazy for fasting before, but hey, we're going to do it. So, let's get ready. So one thing I haven't done in a while and I kind of miss doing, and that's answering Snapchat questions. You know, I get tons of questions every day and I can't answer them all. So at least I can answer some on the YouTube channel. So about to answer some. Here we go. Okay, so first question, the guy wants to know what kind of BCAAs am I currently taking. As of right now, I'm not taking any BCAAs. As you guys know, if you watch a lot of my videos, I have said this in the past, BCAAs can knock you out of ketosis. I'm actually pretty sure it will. And just to be 100% safe, don't take them. Now, that depends on what your goals are. Now, remember, not everyone's goal is to get shredded. Not everyone's goal is to lose body fat. Some people do keto diet just because they love it and it makes them feel good and they love the lifestyle. They could care less about how much body fat they lose, trying to get shredded, trying to lose weight. They just do keto because they like it. So depending on your goals, you know, if you want to take BCAAs, you'll be fine. I'm just saying it's going to knock you out of ketosis. So for someone like me who's trying to lose as much body fat as possible and trying to get as shredded as possible, I just stay away. So if you guys watched my last video, you guys saw that I introduced this like low carb bread company. I believe that's what they're called. Yeah, low carb bread company. Check them out. I put them in the link below. But they have amazing products. They have bread, they have pizza crusts, they have muffins, and they're all great keto products because they're very, very high in fiber. I think like each slice of bread is only 1 gram of carbs. Like that is absolutely amazing. So the company is called Great Low Bread Company. great low carb bread company. I'm sorry. And again, I have no affiliation with them. I do not work for them. I don't have a discount code. They just have amazing stuff and I highly, highly recommend them. Okay, so great question. He wants to know if I take estrogenous ketones. And if you guys are into the keto diet, you know that this keto OS, these keto salts have really taken off over the last past couple of months. Now, I will say this, I don't know too much about them. I have had companies send me some keto salts and estrogenous ketones, and I have taken some. But I just don't know enough, and I haven't had enough of it to see if it makes a difference. You know, supposedly it's supposed to give you a lot of energy. It's supposed to, like, just mental clarity. You're supposed to be able to focus. It's pretty much like a pre-workout or an energy drink for keto. So at least that's what I know. I can answer this question better in future videos.
Hey, Goody, what's up? I play soccer with my friends, and I noticed that since I started keto 2 months ago, my stamina dropped.
All right, great question. So he just started the keto diet and he's noticed that his stamina is going down. A common mistake that new keto people do when they start on the keto diet is they're not drinking enough water, they're not replenishing their electrolytes, they're not getting enough sodium, and they're not getting enough potassium. All those things you need when you're doing the keto diet. If you just start and you don't get those things, you're gonna get foggy. You're gonna feel like crap. You're gonna have no energy. Your stamina is gonna be like crap. You got to make sure, guys, you're getting enough salt, you're getting enough magnesium, and you're getting enough potassium, and you're drinking enough water. If you're doing all those things, I promise you, you'll feel fine, you'll have plenty of energy, and your stamina most likely will be okay. So I hope that answers your question. Remember, those things are important, guys. I talk about this all the time. Get those four things, and I promise you, you'll be fine. So just got to Fit Factory, about to get ready to do 17.5. So let me tell you a little bit about the workout. So it is 9 thrusters. What thrusters are, it's pretty much like almost like a power clean, but at the top, you push out, all the way out, lock out, and then you come all the way down. Or you come down first, then push all the way out. So yeah, I think pretty much I got it. And then 35 double unders. If you don't know what double unders are, they are jump ropes and you go twice around on one jump. Now, I haven't quite got that rhythm down. We did practice that last week, but I haven't quite got that down yet. So I'm not sure. Kind of interested to see what the scale down version is on that particular exercise. If not, then I'll just do 35 jump rope. But it is 10 rounds with a 40-minute time limit. Now, 40 minutes, I don't plan on taking that long. I'm hoping to get done within 15. I'm hoping. All the other ones have just absolutely kicked my butt. I've done absolutely terrible. I'm hoping to go out with a bang on this one, just give it my absolute all. But the most important thing, I want to have fun. I mean, and that's what I've been doing, guys. I've been really having fun with this, like, CrossFit series, the CrossFit Open. I really have. It's something new to me. It's definitely motivating to come in here and get my butt whipped by girls, guys. You know, I'm not used to that. I'm not used to going to the gym and getting my butt whipped, man. I'm used to going in the gym and people are coming up to me asking me for advice. So it's really humbling and I love it. I really do. So, like I said, it is the last workout of the 2017 CrossFit Open. I hope you guys enjoyed this series. Let's get warmed up. Let's get ready in 3, 2, 1. What's up? What's up, dude? You ready for this?
Yeah. I make the city move. I do. I make the city move.
You ready for this?
What's up, dude? How are you?
She done, 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 she done,
right, guys, so the CrossFit Open Games is over. 17.5 was honestly my best workout out of them all. It just felt good. I was able to keep the pace. I only had to stop on 3 and 4, but then after that, I just kept the momentum going. I just felt really good. I did rest a lot, but it just felt good, and I felt like that was probably my best one out of them all. I just want to recap over the 17.5, and actually, I want to just recap on all the CrossFit games and just kind of give you my 2 cents. It was definitely an experience that I did not expect. If you would have told me how the CrossFit games was going to go 5 weeks ago, I wouldn't have believed you. Like, I just didn't anticipate, and I didn't think it was going to be this way. And it's fun, man. I absolutely had a blast. I learned so many new movements. I learned so many new things. I learned so many new things about myself to push myself more. It's just, I'm having fun, guys. And at the end of the day, that's what it's all about. If you're doing something that's fun, you'll keep doing it. You'll keep sustaining it. I think I'm leaning out. I'm pretty sure I'm keeping my muscle. I'm pretty sure I'm keeping my gains or whatever you want to call it. I'm really not worried about that because I feel good. I mean, it's crazy. In the mornings I wake up and I have body parts that are sore on my body that I've never been sore before. And again, I've been doing bodybuilding for 4 years, and I'm waking up like, oh my gosh, I'm so sore because I'm using muscles and I'm doing movements that I'd never had before. And it's just something cool. It's something different, and it's something pretty cool. So I'm definitely enjoying it. So for all of you who I know there's a lot of you on my channel who not CrossFit, man. Just don't knock it till you try it. It's fun. Now, look, I'm not knocking bodybuilding. I love bodybuilding. It's fun. I just needed something new. I needed something to change. I needed something different in my life. And CrossFit is doing that right now. It's replacing bodybuilding, and I'm having fun with it. So for all you who talk crap about CrossFit and haven't tried it, go try it out, man. Just give it a try. It's the same thing we say about keto, man. When we start talking about the keto diet, people think we're crazy. But we're not. Keto is just awesome. It's a lifestyle, and if you only knew the benefits from it, trust me, more people would do it. And so that's what we're trying to spread. That's what we're trying to do. We're trying to motivate, trying to get you to do things that you're not comfortable with. Think outside the box. So that's gonna be it for this CrossFit Open series. I hope you guys did enjoy it. If you did, please, guys, give it a thumbs up. I really do appreciate it, and it really does help my channel. We just hit 35,000 subscribers, guys, this month. We just hit 35. Like, that is awesome. I wanna tell you guys, thank you, thank you, thank you. If it wasn't for you, I couldn't be doing this today. I wouldn't be doing this. The amount of support that I get from you guys is just amazing. Thank you so much. If you guys really did like this video, share it on your Facebook. That's like the best way for us YouTubers to get discovered. And I would truly, truly appreciate it. But that's gonna be it, guys. We'll see you on the next one. Peace.